Baptist preacher, the prophet, the psychic, coming back at you again with another video. People, y'all know why I'm smiling, because I'm happy. I love when a problem is solved. People, listen, y'all. Tuna, I assume they not, they didn't say they were Nadal fans, and they could have. Now, they may not be Nadal fans, but I want to respond to them, people, because they just answered the question. They don't realize they answered the question about whether Federer is the GOAT over Nadal. Actually, you know what? They actually don't realize what they did. They just said Federer is arguably the GOAT, period. I would say arguably. It's definitely arguably, meaning there is some doubt there. I mean, there's always some doubt. Okay. Now, people, listen. Let me respond, and I'm going to answer the question based on the comment. Let me get it right. I got to remember this. This is Kaylon. I think this is her name. I guess it's a lady. Okay. Kaylon. Kaylon says, you can't just... Okay, they acknowledge, both of the commenters, they acknowledge that this is a good question. That why is Federer... So they're not doubting the question I asked. Why is Federer... If Nadal is the GOAT over Federer, then why isn't Nadal... why isn't he the favorite in three out of the four majors, and only he's the favorite for the French Open? So Kaylon says, well, you just can't use that question to determine the GOAT. And another couple other commenters said that. People, listen. Guess what, people? Kaylon is right. But that's not what I'm doing. People, listen. That is a... Okay, people, I use that as a... People, that is that does say a lot that Federer is 37 years old and is playing at this level and being as dominant. But people, here's what Kaylon, let me see what Kaylon, I mean, that's company, the other commenter that said this here. No, but let me go back to Kaylon's comment. So she said that you cannot use that as the ultimate thing, that just because Federer is 37 and winning now, she said, and the other commenter said this too, you got to look at their whole career. People, I agree. But people, listen. People, listen. Listen, people, listen, 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 listen. Y'all get this. People, go to Wikipedia. People, Wikipedia says this. People, Wikipedia says that Federer is regarded by most as the greatest of all time. Go to Wikipedia under Nadal's thing. Wikipedia doesn't say that about Nadal. They say Nadal is one of the top greatest of all time. Okay, they don't even say that about Djokovic, even in his peak. But Wikipedia, not just a tennis prophet, says Federer is regarded as the greatest of all time. Now, people, Kaylon also says something else. She said, well, if you go back a few years ago, who was the GOAT then? Hey, Kaylon, listen, let me say something, people. There was a lot of doubt about Federer a few years ago. There's some doubt now. But people, most experts, including Wikipedia, most experts always kept Federer as the number one. Federer was never, I'm talking about, if you look at the majority of experts, even people that, I mean, that was doubt. Like, well, how can a guy be the GOAT if he didn't dominate his rivals? We heard that. But people, still the majority of experts, Federer was never number two to Nadal. I'm talking about generally. I have never seen, even with Federer's lowest point in his career, during the Nadal rivalry, Nadal, the Djokovic rivalry, say when Federer dropped to his bottom low, people, he was never number two, though. As I'm talking about, as far as the GOAT debate. Now, he was number two as far as his actual level of play or who was the best player during this year, whatever. But Federer, to Kaylon, she's acting like most experts consider the Djokovic or Nadal to be the GOAT. That was never so. But was there doubt about Federer? Oh, yeah, of course. And at one point, there was a lot of doubt. But people, Federer was always number one as far as the GOAT. Of course, if anybody want to try to, I'm talking about, listen, people, there was, now, listen, don't go sending me something Agassi said. Don't go sending me something one or two experts said about, well, if you didn't dominate your rivals. I'm talking about the majority of experts. Even, you know when they do that ranking, ESPN do the ranking, CBS Sports, the Tennis Channel, Federer was always number one as the GOAT. Okay? Y'all, I'm just letting y'all know. This ain't just a tennis prophet making this up. Okay, now, let me say, is there anything else? Okay, people, now listen. The thing that Kalon said about that. I can't just use that question as a 100% measurement of who the GOAT is. She's right. But here's the problem, Kalon. If you take, here's the problem for Nadal fans, and Nadal knows this. See, that's why y'all heard Nadal say, Federer got too many. And even Nadal said, I can't worry. Y'all heard Nadal last week? He said, I can't worry about this. This guy got so much. If I become the GOAT and surpass him, fine. But I can't worry about that. Listen, people, the reason why Federer is the GOAT, it ain't just that he's playing at this level at 37 years old. People, he got more achievements than everybody else. See, Kalon, listen, Kalon acting like I'm saying, okay, Federer is 37 years old and he's playing at such a high level. That's why he's the GOAT. No, if you put the 37-year-old dominant Federer with all of his achievements, not just majors. See, historian, the reason why historians never put Federer, I don't care what Nadal fans have done. They put Federer number two to Nadal. The reason why historians never did that, listen, people, Federer has been in more finals than Nadal. Federer's been, he's been in more semifinals. It's not even close with the semifinals. That matters. How many times have you pushed into the semifinals over the years? Federer got six ATP finales? I mean, Nadal has zero. Federer been number one for five consecutive years. Man, I could go, he got more majors. So if you put Federer's total achievements with this resurgence Federer at the age of 36, 37, that's why he's the GOAT. So now I got to go to company, what she was saying. Okay, company was saying the same thing pretty well, that she was saying you can't, well, I don't know if it's a he or she, but company was saying that you can't use the 37-year-old high-level Federer, or that he's the favorite in three majors as the ultimate determinant that he's the GOAT. I agree with that, but here's the problem for Nadal and all these other people, even the Djokovic. Not only is Federer so dominant at the age of 37, 5 years older than Nadal, he got more achievements than Nadal. You understand? See, listen, people, if it was this way, let's suppose Nadal had 22 majors, all right, and Federer had 17. And then, let's say Federer was older than Nadal, okay, Federer got 17 majors, let's reverse it. Federer got 17 majors, but he's winning like he's winning now at the age of 37. Okay, people, in that case, the dominance at the age of 37 would only mean so much because Federer wouldn't have the achievements to top Nadal. But people, he has the achievements. Not only does he have the longevity, he has the achievements. When you put those two together, that's why Wikipedia, not just the tennis prophet, the Wikipedia doesn't say Nadal is regarded as the GOAT. They don't say the Djokovic. Even the Djokovic could have been the GOAT if he would have been able to sustain for three more years. But Wikipedia, not just the tennis prophet, historians say Federer is arguably the GOAT. Okay? I don't know if I missed one. I don't know. There could have been something else company was saying that I could have missed, but I think that sums it up. Okay, people. Tennis preacher, tennis prophet, tennis psychic. Have a good one.
Dance. Ooh, yeah, you can dance too. That's the way his name is.